Michael Addo with the latest in the world of news. All right, so let's come back in studio and talk about VSO. I'm sure, like I mentioned earlier, a number of you may have seen VSO, just the letters on huge billboards and buildings around, but you may not know what they are into or what they do. I have two personnel with me in studio. We're going to be talking about what VSO stands for, what it is, how long they've been in Ghana, what their future plans are like. And we are told that there is a special program coming out later this week. There has already been the global launch, and then they're going to focus specifically on Ghana. Let me introduce them, then we can go straight into the discussion. We have the country director for VSO, which stands for the Voluntary Services Overseas. I'm talking about Sanjay Awasti. Good morning.
Morning.
And then also we have Kojo Williams. He is the chief executive officer for Center for CSR, and he's also joined us in studio. Center for CSR West Africa specific. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, good to have you with us. Let me start with you, Sanjay. I mentioned to you earlier that I had seen VSO on one or two buildings and some vehicles with VSO written on. What is VSO, and what really is your mandate? What do you do?
Okay, VSO, as you rightly mentioned, stands for Voluntary Service Overseas. It's an international organization headquartered in the UK.
Okay.
And in Ghana, we have been probably for the longest period. We established our office in Ghana in 1958, which was
58?
Just 1958, wow. Which was just a year after Ghana became independent. And we specialize in designing social development programs and projects, and where volunteers play a very significant role.
Mm.
And when we started in the 50s and 60s and 70s, most of these African and Asian countries were gradually getting independent. And they had a basic skills shortage. They didn't have enough teachers, they didn't have enough doctors and paramedics and so on. So it was very common for young British volunteers to come down to these countries, including Ghana, and then spend some time, almost a year or two, in teaching or in just volunteering in a hospital.
Oh.
But then over the period, the capacity in these countries gradually improved, and now they don't need people to teach.
Okay.
They need people who can bring in specialized knowledge and support, and who can actually advise the government teachers, who can advise the district directors of education, and same with so many other departments in the government, as well as in the civil society organizations.
Okay, but if you say voluntary, I get the feeling that it meant that you do it, you're not paid anything. You, what do you provide for those who then volunteer to serve?
Okay, the idea behind this is that anybody who actually decides to volunteer is taking time off from his busy schedule, a well-paying job,
okay,
just to come and do something good for the people. Now, it is our responsibility to ensure that the person doesn't have to spend anything from his pocket.
Okay.
So, for example, we provide a very basic housing to international volunteers.
Okay.
We provide a very basic allowance for them to subsist, but we don't give them any handsome salary.
Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah. I get it now. Right. Let me bring you in, Kojo. You are with the civil society group. Well, let me put it properly in context. You are with CSR West Africa. What is the mandate of CSR West Africa?
Well, Center for CSR basically is an organization that tries to create awareness about corporate social responsibility and educate corporate organizations and stakeholders generally, including the media, you know, about corporate social responsibility. We some few years back, we conducted a research and discovered that the concept of CSR is not yet demystified. So many people, so many stakeholders have misconceptions about CSR. Some think it is something that you do once a year. Some think because of their religious background, when you know they give back to society, nobody must know about it. Some think, well, it's the duty of the multinationals; they have the big money, so they should give back to society.
Mm-hmm.
Some think, well, I pay taxes, you know, probably as an organization or as an individual, so I don't need to engage in all of that. Everything else is meant for the government to do, and all of that. So, for the few years that we've been in existence, we we've been trying to re-educate, I mean, we've been trying to educate and create awareness about CSR, and also about the fact that, you know, the world is moving on gradually, you know, beyond, you know, just corporate social responsibility to sustainability. Recently, just last year, we all, I mean, got the news that the MDGs, the Millennium Development Goals, gave way to the SDGs, the Sustainable Development Goals, meaning that the world is moving on fast, and then we in this part of the world need to, you know, catch up fast. And so the responsibility is not just only on organizations, but also on individuals.
Okay.
So that is the reason why corporate voluntarism, for instance, is one key area that we, you know, advise organizations to get involved in.
And that will bring me to my next question. What is the kind of partnership we are looking at between CSO West Africa and then also what VSO has been doing in Ghana?
Yes. Right now, the VSO is launching the knowledge exchange, you know, program, and it is targeted at, you know, professionals, you know, corporate professionals, for instance, and we have a very good relationship with corporate organizations in Ghana, and it's one of the mandates that we have to push them to be socially responsible, to give back to society, to make sure that they have a program. You know, as organizations, they have a program that is woven into the integral part of doing business, that they allow their workers, you know, to give off their time, you know, to volunteer and give back to society meaningfully. So in that context, we would be, you know, helping VSO to get the large junk of, you know, professionals that they need, okay, you know, to be able to
deliver on
your mandate.
Okay. Sanjay, 50, so how many years have been gonna, I mean,
more than 55
years. Okay. Out of that, we're told this year certainly the VSO has changed over time, and now your focus is going to be more on corporate, how we can get the corporate institutions to also get involved in volunteering. This year, we are told you are launching knowledge exchange, VSO knowledge exchange. If I just put it right, you're calling it the VSO knowledge exchange. That's right. What is, how different is it from what you've already been doing?
It's not very different in terms of the basic concept of volunteering.
Mm-hmm.
It's an extension of what we've already been doing, extending it to a new domain in terms of corporate professionals. And this initiative has been launched with support from British DFID, Department for International Development. And the global launch happened in July. And Ghana happens to be one of the focus countries under this initiative for VSO. Mm-hmm. And that is how we decided to have a launch in Ghana later this week.
Are there specific areas you're looking at?
We basically want to link up the private sector professionals with the demand in the development sector.
Okay.
So, for example, you come across so many good organizations who are doing excellent work in a range of development issues. But then, apart from that commitment, there is also a desire to bring in certain level of efficiency, which we normally see in the private sector.
Okay, yeah.
And one of the best ways of doing that is getting these corporate professionals to come and volunteer and pass on some of their skills to this sector. So we already have, we've had a partnership with few very well-known companies globally. For example, Accenture, okay, is a well-known, yeah, consultancy company. And we have had a long-standing partnership with Accenture, enabling them to provide their professionals for voluntary work in the development sector.
Mm.
We have also had a similar partnership with Randstad. It's also a very well-known international consultancy company which focuses on HR related issues.
Mm.
So similarly, we are in the process of forging similar partnerships with several other companies.
Mm.
And as Kojo mentioned, that we intend to do something similar in Ghana. Just going beyond, not just remaining confined to the multinational corporations, but also targeting the national companies,
mm,
and persuading them to spare their staff to give back to the society.
All right.
Exactly.
So what is your role going to be in this, if you can help us with some specifics?
Basically, we have been working with a number of organizations, like the Association of Ghana Industries, okay, like the Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and all of that. So we would be pushing them, you know, to have their member organizations, you know, the companies that make up all these business associations, will be pushing for them to have a program, you know, in their organizations that allow their employees to have some time that, you know, they dedicate, you know, to give out or to give back to society. Mm-hmm. And this is the benefits are enormous, you know, for the organization and also, you know, for the individual. For instance, for the organization, it helps to, you know, improve employee engagement. It helps to improve quality and productivity. Yes, and networking and all of that. And there are so many, you know, studies that have been, you know, conducted, you know, about organizations that allow their employees to, you know, give up some of their time, you know, to society. And in some of those studies, productivity and profitability increase between 15% and 18%, and that is, you know, major for some of this organization. And also for the individual, you are able to, you know, have a good sense of self-worth. You could even, you know, cite some of the things that you do on your, I mean, self-references on your CV and all of that. So it's beneficial to both of the organization and the individual.
So tell us about the Ghana launch, venue, time, and all the other details that we need to know about.
Okay, the Ghana launch is scheduled for Friday the 12th, 8 o'clock in the morning at the British Council Auditorium. We are bringing in a range of a cross section of speakers from the private sector as well as the development sector, and who are going to speak about the benefits of professional volunteering, corporate employee, and professional volunteering. And Kojo is also going to be with us. Okay. Based on his experience, he's going to speak about the benefits which he just now mentioned. So that's something.
And is it a day's activity, 1 week, 1 month, or what is the timetable like?
It's going to be a long-term engagement.
Okay.
As of now, we have realized, based on our discussions with a number of companies, that it may not be possible for them to spare their employees for too long a duration.
Mm-hmm.
So we have settled for an average duration of around 3 to 4 months, and our past experience has shown that if we are really clear in terms of what we expect that professional to do for us, that also goes a long way in helping our objectives.
Okay, well, I am looking forward to volunteering. That's if individuals will be allowed.
Oh,
but if it's more corporate level and there are individuals who are also interested, how can they get in touch with you if they want to volunteer? How can they contact you?
You can contact our office.
Mm-hmm.
I leave behind our contact details. We
okay.
have a full-time colleague who looks after this initiative in Ghana.
Okay.
And she'll be more than happy to put you in touch with the organizations who would require services from people like you.
Volunteers. Okay. All right. Final words from you, Kojo.
I would encourage organizations and individuals to give back some of their time, you know, to society. And this year is packed for the Center for CSR. We are looking forward to the 6th edition of the Ghana CSR Excellence Award.
Mm-hmm.
We're also looking at CSR reporting for journalists. We're training journalists on how to report on CSR. And also we're looking at the sustainability conference in May.
Right. I see. Okay. So yes, you have any final words when we can, anything else you want to add to this?
I'll only request our viewers and especially our private sector professionals that please think beyond your comfort level. Think about the people who don't have access to the facilities and basic comforts that you have. And a little of your time will go a long way in helping the Ghanaian society.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Sanjay Awashti. He's country director for the VSO Ghana. That is the voluntary service overseas, and also we had Kojo Williams, who is the Chief Executive Officer for Center for CSR West Africa, and they were helping us understand the issue of how you and your institution, as a corporate institutions, can help volunteer personnel to better the lives of people who may not be getting those services, or who may be needing those services. Thank you very much once again, gentlemen, for joining us.